Oh, wait a minute. Do I have some? No, no. Oh, I think I have it. Oh, oh, I got it. Oh, hey, Nicholas, come on in. Got it.
Jack, how are you? Are you doing yoga?
Now, I know that's what it looks like, Nicholas, but I just can't seem to get Wi-Fi signal in this part of the house.
Well, I have a possible solution for you. It's called a mesh network.
How convenient. I love it when my friends from Consumer Reports come around and just happen to have a possible answer to my problems right in their bag.
What is that?
The way they work is rather than having one device per router kind of spread Wi-Fi all over the house, this has a series of devices that work together to give you faster speeds and better coverage.
But will this little white box work better than my little black box?
Well, Jack, this is a nice router, but look where it is. We're in the basement. We're several feet on the ground. These walls are concrete. No Wi-Fi signal is going to get out of here.
Well, unfortunately, Nicholas, I can't move this because this is where the internet wiring is.
Okay, that's cool, but that's where the mesh network comes in, because you can put the main unit here and then have the satellite units, for example, in a bedroom or the living room, and that way you'll get uniform Wi-Fi coverage throughout your house, even though the main unit is down here in the basement.
Once Nicholas has the central mesh unit installed beside the router, we go back upstairs to start adding the satellites.
Now, what types of homes are these good for?
It's really any home that has issues with dead zones and drops and slow speeds, that type of thing.
What are the differences then between a mesh network and a repeater or an extender?
They're both trying to accomplish the same goal, which is just to improve Wi-Fi coverage throughout your house. Mm-hmm. But the main difference is an extender will often deliver slower speeds, and you'll often have differences with Wi-Fi network names, which can be very confusing depending upon whether or not your laptop is configured to change between those different networks. Whereas a mesh network, you don't have to worry about any of that.
Now, what about price points? Are these things very expensive?
Well, that's kind of the trade-off. Mesh networks are a little bit more expensive than traditional wireless routers.
Nicholas, I'm just very curious. How do you know all this stuff?
We actually have a dedicated facility where we test all these products, you know, wireless routers, mesh networks, that type of thing. Mm-hmm. And when it comes to wireless routers, there are two main things that we look at. We look at performance and we look at distance. And we're just trying to get a good idea of like how these routers perform in a typical house environment. And so we can help folks, you know, make smarter decisions when they're shopping for a router.
And one of the handiest tools of the trade is this phone app.
This is kind of looking at all the Wi-Fi networks in the general area, and this is showing the mesh network that we had set up earlier. This is showing that the mesh network that we've set up is doing its job because we're getting a very strong signal here.
So can we put some more of these around the house?
Yeah, that's a great idea. Really, the more the merrier here.
That'd be great. Let's do it. That's it! Nicholas, get in here!
What's going on? I thought we set this up. Are you still having signal problems?
No, no, the Wi-Fi signal is working great, thanks to you. I'm just watching my yoga classes that I wanted to see.
Oh, cool.
Hey, do you want to come join me?
Sure.
Yeah, come on, man. Come on, let's go. Oh, I love this right here. Ready?
Yeah.
Now I feel connected.
Oh.